Welcome to the show.
Wagwan.
So,
you alright?
I'm good, Thank you for joining us. Mm-hmm. So before we get into you performing, we wanted to ask, for the listeners who don't know who you are, haven't heard your music before, mm-hmm. how did you get your start writing music?
I was always writing music, but I wasn't always writing rap music. I'm talking like primary school when everybody wanted to be like Boyzone or something.
Yeah.
Do you know what I'm saying? Yeah. But people would laugh at my tunes, innit? So I got put off. And then you're hearing one of my lyrics, innit? That I used to get into trouble at school, like anger management wise. And then my social workers would be like, oh, if you feel like something, then write it down. And then
it was a way to deal with emotions and adolescence.
Yeah, like therapeutically. But then obviously, like, I got older and I started listening to more rap music. And my first tune that really made me want to write was a tune by Exhibit called What a Mess. I heard it on Tim Westwood Show. Them days when you used to record Tim Westwood shows,
yeah.
And just pff, all the time. But yeah, that tune like made me stop and think, and then I kind of like started going deeper into just writing in general. I mean, that's the only thing, English is the only thing I write based off of. So.
Did you experiment with writing poetry, or was it always you wanted to connect it to music?
I've done some kind of poetry, but I've always kind of put them in the same bracket. Not that I know that they're different in the sense that obviously poetry, you can read it and you can kind of say it and express it how you want to, but mm-hmm. I try and be as poetic as I can lyrically anyway.
Yeah.
But I enjoyed doing poetry and stuff in school and stuff, so I really liked the breaking down of words. And like with flows and stuff, I always catch that if you want to have a particular kind of flow, then you have to be pretty poetic to make it sound work, to make it work. Do you know what I mean?
So it's from teenage years is when you started, though.
Yeah, probably like when 8 Mile came out and all my mates and that, we'd all go out, we'd write lyrics in class, like while we're supposed to be learning.
Yeah.
And like go out at lunchtime and break time and like battle each other.
So you started with like Eminem style?
Yeah, 8 Mile stuff. Yeah. It was literally when 8 Mile came out, everybody was hyped. You know, I was pretty good even then. And then loads of stuff. I got into music from early anyway. You know what I mean? So it was Michael Jackson, and then there was church, and then there was reggae music.
It's all sort of bled into it. Yeah.
So,
cool. So you've introduced us by a word description. So let's introduce you to some music. You're gonna do "Rushing to Save You" live for us now.
Yeah. Certified inside, yo, MiliDee. I'm in the waiting room, waiting to hear my ticket number. Hoping I make it through, make it over this shit I'm under. Hearing my favourite tunes, chat to the snares and kicks, I wonder. Chasing the dream, but am I fit enough to run for it? Hell yeah. Like a cage beast, boarded if I stomach pit, my hunger is. I'm living in this dead end city, you know I long to live. You know how long I feel to take this game and conquer it. From back when we was knocking conkers and kids, cause back then I was writing deep because my social worker told me when I'm angry I should grab pens. Back then me and my bro Joe were anti-social, fuck the teachers. They don't know or care about developing a pair of black men. And we was too young to know that's how this ting goes. But I've been deep since my underpants and vest was my gym clothes. Yo, and I saw the ting go. Yo, nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. Only who can save you is you. Yo, dread is the judges in vendettas and grudges. So fuck it, you'll never to touch it. I'm way out of your budget. You blew it like the prophet. I do this like no other, can't do it like I does it. I bust the mold, you mold it. Didn't believe I'd even bug it with the flows I bring. This man is his own republic. So who are you to fuck with? The most of much is from the town of ghosts. You puppet shows, no frozen muppets. How you gonna pocket go like cock a block it? Yo, nobody's rushing to save you. Yo, nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. The only person who can save you is you. Yo, nobody's rushing. My bullets, I clip them into my subconscious magazine. The container, I load and lock this container into my brain. That's the chamber, my eyes provide the sight. So I align my sights with something to aim at. My mind's locked in anticipation. My mind and body held together with a slide. Like my actions manifest my thoughts like firing pins. Brought to life by the release and the tension and stress in my firing springs.
Hooked to the feelings in my heart, they're the trigger. The truth I figure knocks me back like the hammer. I understand you now. Now all I wanna do is blame me down for trying to use me against my will like barrel. My mouth, my limbs and all my extremities will be the barrel through which these thoughts can travel. And like God, my will is my guide. Work, but karma is the safety. Having you hoping that maybe I'll change my mind. Nah, it's your time. Yo, nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. The only one who can save you is you, yo. Nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. Nobody's rushing to save you. The only person who can save you is you. MiliDee certified and signed new radio show, Shoreditch Radio. Hold tight, wife, inside. Hold tight, all of them.
It's not actually a tune. I just made that chorus up.
Oh, okay, you did that live for us.
Yeah. I've done another. I've recorded that one quite a while ago. But on the way here, I had like a set list, and I just decided at the last minute because I started going through my mate Jag's beats on the way down, man, to just practice some lyrics. And that. I might do something different today. Jagstrumentals. He's one of the guys that we sit next to in school, and he drumming on the table and stuff. And stuff. He got me into quite a lot of the music that I listened to.
Okay.
He was rich enough to have CDs.
So he was the one who exposed you, the guy who produces you now?
Yeah, a lot of my friends and that. Like, I obviously knew a lot of what was going on with hip hop, but at the same time, it's digging the crates back and finding all the proper old classics and that. He proper worships J. Dilla.
Yeah.
So that's
you can hear that a lot in his beats.
Yeah. So. He creates them. He's been making these for ages. In fact, he got me back into rapping. Because I stopped rapping for a while. Because I was doing quite a lot of stuff when I was younger. Like, I had me and my mate, Matty, was trying to make a one little record label for me.
Oh, cool.
It was called GTM, Ghost Town Movements, after the specials.
Yeah.
You know the song Ghost Town?
Yeah.
The video was in Coventry when I grew up.
Mm-hmm.
So, I basically took that and made the name. And, we did, two club nights. We did, under 18s performance night, which went well, and then we did an over 18s night, which didn't go so well. It was a bit of a mess. We never really did nothing. But back then, times there, I used to get studio at the Herbert Art Gallery in Coventry from 5 in the evening till 8 in the morning. Because he did the course there, it was £25 that we could hire that studio. So we used to just get geezers in, even guys at that. We just brought loads of people in and just got into recording that. There was quite a lot of people in Coventry at the time, especially with grime and stuff like that. There's quite a few now, my room still spits as well. My room's called something, he does quite a lot of stuff, he's really sick. And there's another year called Scatter that lives around the corner. And they're people that have been around, they're not brand new, they've been around for ages, but they were younger, and now they're doing really well. But before, there was it was the hype times, and crazy tea and all of that, and there was loads of grime beefs and everything in comedy. So there was loads of different MCs in comedy times. So I tried my best to make a unit out of that.
So it was a really good environment to be making music in. There's a lot of inspiration good.
Yeah, there was a lot. It was buzzing, wasn't it?
It
was buzzing. It was good.
So your influences, you kind of mentioned about Exhibit before, was the first kind of person you heard, and Eminem got you into battling and stuff. You've chosen your artist track tonight. Do you want to explain why you chose this particular artist?
Yeah, because it has nothing to do with any of those other tunes.
So who have you chosen?
It's by Bilal, and I'm not a massive, I don't know all of his tunes. I only know this tune and another tune called Robots, but it's called All That I Am. And I only discovered it I've had it on my phone for ages, but you know when you've got so much music that you haven't really heard all of them, and I've just stumbled.
Everything gets lost.
Yeah, but you know, it was one of them moments when you're feeling something and you're feeling a certain way, and then this tune comes on, you're that's not how I feel right now.
It got you in that moment.
Yeah, it got me, man. I almost cried. I didn't really cry, I just started being funky. But I like it because I like all kind of different genres of music.
Yeah.
If I like the vibe, if I like the bass, if I like the melody of it, I'll listen to it. And, obviously hip hop and bashment and what they call urban music is my main thing. But this is still classic soul, I guess.
Yeah, it's more neo-soul,
more neo-soul, yeah, yeah, exactly. I love a bit of neo-soul. Mm-hmm. But, like, it's the lyrics that I like, do you know what I mean? Like, I like the chorus, and I like the kind of content of the tune, do you know what I mean? Like, it's like, I can relate to some bits of it, and the chorus, it just kind of makes you feel good, like, as an artist, because that's how I kind of picture myself as an artist. What I do with my art is I kind of use my experiences and analyze myself, analyze what's around me. And the chorus is like, oh, that I am, oh, that I know, you get me? And it all goes into this thing that's kind of determines where you're going. So I thought I know why I like the tune, and like you'd be able to, if you could feel it, you could feel it.
Yeah.
Those that I like tunes like that.
Kind of soulful, meaningful. Yeah.
I'd spit out stuff like that if I had the right producer. I'd spit. Jag makes similar stuff like that, but like his is more like boom bap, proper like that kind of early 90s New York.
Yeah, it's definitely, you can hear that kind of early 90s Jay Dilla vibe. Cool. So let's play your artist choice track right now. Two tracks of your live session. We wanted to hear a bit about what's next for MiliDee. So you're kindly doing a show for us.
Yeah. Well, what's the name? Where was it at that?
I'll remind you before.
Yeah,
as well.
I always remind you.
So it's Cafe 1001. We are live.
That's got, Brick Lane. Right?
Yeah, Brick Lane. We've got you, Mr. Mackie, who's previous session guest, and Legacy, who were in a few weeks ago, performing live for us at Cafe 1000, and it is the 19th of October, so it's going to be a great night. Free entry, so come along and join some UK hip-hop.
I'm going to be there.
Yeah, he's going to do a great set. And what else is next for you? You recording, you're writing, more gigs?
I'm always writing, I record, because I'm at uni, I do drama and media at uni, so I kind of use their studios down there, but it's just organising everything at the moment, and obviously I'm going to go back down to Coventry. And I've got loads of Jag's beats anyway, like all of those beats are made by Jag, as I said, like my mate that made my beats for me. So I kind of do it when I get a chance to, but when I finally get a chance to like have like a stable place where I record, then I can just do it. The dream is to have like a place where I can draw, where I can record, and where I can do pretty much anything that I want to do. Like
all your creative stuff in one room.
Yeah, because I do quite a lot of stuff at the moment. Like I've got two comic books that I'm drawing.
Oh, fantastic!
Like, hand draw them, and one of them I coloured in like piece by piece. It's taken me about 5 years. I'm working on it.
Oh wow!
You know what I mean, one's called The Men in Barker Scrolls. That was the first one I came up with. And the other one's called The Mystical Legend of Eagle Rass. And if you go on my Instagram at MiliDee, or if you just go on Instagram and you hashtag MiliDee Art, that's MiliDee Art, all is one word, then you can see little pictures, like some, you can see a lot of my drawings and stuff.
Would you like to do your own artwork for when you release more music? Is that the plan?
Yeah. Well, it's like I've got a lot of different ideas, because I like to. Like I said, like some part of the reason why I like that tune is like, I mean, he says it like it's something for the people, do you know what I mean? Like, so I'm kind of making like a kind of black British, mangery, boondocksy kind of thing. Because if you got a talent, if you're talented at something, I guess you might as well use it. And I happened to come up with a couple of characters and it just kind of spiraled off from there.
Mm-hmm.
And they're both interlinked stories. Like, I can show you, I'll show you some pictures there. So that should be done hopefully by, I'm trying to give myself a deadline to have it totally done by the end of uni, which is like around March, June-ish. And then hopefully next week I'm going to get a delivery of jackets and t-shirts with a piece of my artwork as the logo. And I'm starting a clothing brand called The Original Lionheart Apparel. And if you abbreviate that, that's OLDA. Respect the older, get one when I release them. You know what I'm saying?
We're
good. Yeah, but I've got so much plans, because I do filming, I do acting, I'm obviously working on the two comic books, and like I'm just waiting. I'm kind of always working on a masterpiece of it. I've got so much lyrics. If I go studio and I just dump all the lyrics on the floor and just sift through them and work out which ones.
So like wading through all the lyrics to get. as much hard work as writing them.
Yeah, exactly, because I enjoy writing. I really do enjoy writing. So, okay.
So if you want to hear more from MiliDee, you can check him out on our live show and on SoundCloud. You're MiliDee.
Yeah, I'm MiliDee on SoundCloud.
So you can see all the videos from tonight's session. But so we're going to leave our session with two more live tracks. We're going to start with Tall Buildings and then Barbarian. So you're going to play us out with those two. Thank you so much for joining us.
You're welcome. I never practiced, didn't
I? They sound good without practice.
Yeah, but at the same time, like, I don't know. It sounds good, but like, next time I'm practicing.
Okay. Like, so you have to come to the live show on the 19th of October to see fully practice.
Full whack.
And a full set of up. Right, thank you for joining us. All and right, we're going to hear Tall Buildings first.
A whole tight wifey, because she's in the room as well filming.
Peace.
Tall Buildings on a different beat for those who know it already. They're saying that this isn't Tall Buildings, but it's Tall Buildings. Listen, yo. Wisdom dipped in the bonnet, put to be in the bonnet of the evil decided to see for Congress of thieves in the offices of Parliament, protected by laws that protect the rich from the poor. And they leave with the profits of war, and leave leading the profits of youth with meagre prospects. While activists be repeating the protest from BC to AD. We need peace to make peace, to leave seeds a great future. But they mark and they mute, you shoot, you elude ya. Might look the devil in his eyes, why? Cause he moves like Medusa. And you got no faith in the true life producer. Thinking tight, but you're moving looser. Exposing your fears to lose to crime. Who senses that like a wild animal and uses that to oppress and abuse ya? No, I ain't begging to get into your tall buildings. Better make way, there's gonna be some more buildings. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. No, I ain't begging to get into your tall buildings. Better make way, there's gonna be some more buildings. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called put good and evil in the blender. Everybody pushing their own agenda behind their regal splendor. Disguised as the defender, the hand lender. Still alert in the senses like when burglars enter. I float like fire in the wind, burning embers. I flow like molten iron and alloy in the mold. Part of the new model, the major component, like major organ. Banner with the upper, playing the organ. Handle that like a doctor, my lyrical anatomy. Deeper than your cynical analogies, transcending spiritual and physical realities. Truth stranger than fiction, holding in sacred insanity. I'm too young to be a sage, but when my mind's engaged, I can calculate and gauge the chemistry just like the medicine man. And I know they say that crime isn't, but does anything pay? I'm trying to grow, but I ain't loving it every day. The bullshit never stops, and it's worse when I trotted it. You know them ways, the sky goes grey. Harder to find God in it, feels a bit hard in it. It's like in some way human DNA has a bomb in it, leading to abomination, spreading disgrace across the human race. From Illuminati, there's nothing to illuminate, mate. Cause no, I ain't begging to get into your tall buildings. Better make way, there's gonna be some more buildings. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. No, I ain't begging to get into your tall buildings. Better make way, there's gonna be some more buildings. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. I'm trying to put you onto this, yo. Tall buildings, overshadowed as small children. Poor witness, scorers, the adults trying to wreck tall buildings. Can't take the pressure, jump from tall buildings. Have you got a future for the youths in them tall buildings? In your building, is there a future without no wars to kill them? Giving them a chance to try and build their own tall buildings. If not like Nino Brown, I'll take your building. I guess you don't know what kind of mistake you're building. Sitting comfortable at the top of your tall building. Let's take you to the streets, I'll be dropping you off from the top of your tall building. Who the fuck think they give a fuck if you made 4 billion? If you couldn't open up the gates to the tall building, to the small children. I'm overlooking the bigger picture from tall buildings. The soldiers trying to learn your families and burn small buildings. I'm trying to build my old tall building. No, I ain't begging to get into your tall building. Better make way, there's gonna be some more buildings. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. I'm trying to put you onto this concept, it's called building. It's called building. Yo, it's called building. It's called building. Yo, it's called building. Certified inside new music show, Shoreditch Radio. Yo, I got that shit that make you wet your neck. He thinks he's got that shit that make you wet your neck. He thinks he's got that shit that make you wet your neck. He thinks he's got this shit that make you wet your neck. Yo, he needs to got this shit that make you wet your neck. Birth of a barbaric barbarian, baby boy pouring and tearing out of his
settlement, all tenement, wild and vile. Barking out saliva, so it's technically venomous. Spy for the liable, at any moment I fly off the handle. And I'm quite forceful, lying with his right hand, lying upon the mind, always Satan and fire, inside the both of his eyeballs. Yo, he thinks he's got that.
I got that shit that make you work your neck. I got that shit that make you work your neck.